We talk so much about what we shouldn't eat rather than thinking about what can we eat. Today, I think it's 75% of what we eat only comes from 12 different species. And in total globally, I think we eat around 150 different species. But there are like 250 or 300,000 of edible species. Around a quarter of all greenhouse gas emissions comes from the food system. Almost 70% of all the water withdrawn for different human uses goes to agriculture. Around 70 to 80% of what drives biodiversity loss and also deforestation is due to what we do in the food sector. So what we eat really has big consequences on the global environment. Generally, research has shown that it is possible to feed 10 billion people a healthy diet within the boundaries of this planet. But right now, the way we consume food substantially transgresses these boundaries. We then need to have dramatic shifts, both in the way in what we eat, to eat both more healthily and more sustainably, but then also what we produce. And not just what we produce, but also how we produce it. So making agriculture more sustainable, that is producing kind of more with less impact. And then we also need to cut food loss and waste. Today we're throwing out 30% of everything that we produce, and we need to at least half all of the food loss and waste that we're producing today. Well, climate-friendly food can definitely be healthy, but climate-friendly food is not always healthy. I mean, if you're substituting beef to pulses, then that's a healthier choice. But if you're substituting meat to potato chips, for example, it's of course not a more healthy choice. So, but it would have a smaller carbon footprint. We also need to have livestock in order to have more circular agricultural systems. So we can use, for example, manure as fertilizers. And livestock is also really good at eating grass, right? So when livestock eat grass, they turn grass into something that we can also eat. So in places where we can't use land for cultivation of crops, to have livestock there that eat the grass and then we eat that, it's a way of using that for food. However, the amount of meat that we're consuming today is just contributing too much to climate change. So we need to eat much less, but better quality, and also eat the meat that has lower environmental impact. One thing is eat less but better meat. That's a really important one, especially for climate. The other one is don't buy anything that you're not eating up. So don't throw away the food that you're buying. And that's also a really important part of it. And the third one is to source what you're buying from better produced, when it's better produced. So either if it's organic production or if it's a farmer, from a farmer that you know is doing a good job on his land. those are things that you can look out for.